Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video we carry on with the Rotary brooch from Hemingway Kits, and in this video we make the locking ring. Now this should have been made first, but I didn't have the drills to do the holes. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. These are the instructions, and we're starting with the locking ring, which is here, and it goes through how you manufacture the ring, what you need. This is the ring. The drawing gives you the diameters, thickness, and here it gives you the thread, M20 by 0.5 or 52 teeth per inch if you're imperial. It also gives you the depth of cut for a 60 degree tool and a 55 degree tool. So that's what we start to make first. We start by taking a 7/8 piece of free cutting mild steel, put that in the 3-jaw chuck. I want it about an inch sticking it out. And just out of interest, we'll check how much it's running out. Look at the highest point. There, bring that to zero. That's one thou, two, three thou run out on that. That should be okay. Now the first thing I need to do is face off the sawn end and centre drill. The next job is to turn the first 10mm of this rod down to 20 diameter. Let's just clean it up, so let's see what the diameter is. 22. Do this and do it in metric or imperial. In imperial that diameter is 0.7, just under 88, and we want 20mm, which is 0.7874. I'll leave it at that. Little room for polishing. I'm changing my tool now for a threading tool. This one, see if I can find the numbers. This one is a high speed steel, 4mm, and it has a 60 degree cutting point, you can see there. And on the other end of it is a little boring bar with the 60 degree for internal threads. So I'll set this up on centre line, set it square, and then I need to change the gears on the end of the lathe to give me a 0.5mm pitch. I'm just using a square on the edge of the tool and setting my tool
square to the chuck.
Okay, to get the correct pitch, which is 0.5 millimeter, I need to change two gears. 0.5, I need a 40 tooth gear on the stud and a 60 tooth gear on the screw. So this needs to be changed for a 60, this one needs to be changed for a 40. And when I change the gears, I always turn the chuck just to check there's no binding on the gears. You can see each gear has a little bit of play in it rather than being locked into the gear. Fit my thread indicator, and on the chart it says a 0.5 pitch is number one gear, which is a 20 tooth gear. There are two gears, one here which is a 21 tooth, and the 20 tooth is already on. So all I need to do is fit that into the hole, engage it on the lead screw and lock it up. Okay, I've slowed the speed down, put the back gear on. Engage it. That's the speed it travels. I have a 60 degree V screw thread cutter. According to the drawing, I need to go in 14 and a half thou, which I think is about 0.368 millimetres. I've put some red felt tip on the part, and I want to go in a few, couple of thou, just to check that the tool is set and that the machine is set to 0.5 millimetres pitch. Engage it. This is a 0.5 millimeter pitch screw thread, and that fits in there, so I've got the right pitch. There you can see how fine that thread is. There's a thread pitch gauge. Okay, the next job is to drill and bore a 10.2mm hole. So first of all, I'll drill this out to 8mm so I can get my boring tool in. This is 7mm. Now I'll change the drill to a 8mm drill. This is 9.45.
says 10.2. Which is 10.23, so should be okay. Now the next jump is bore 16mm diameter, touch the face, then go in 0.5. Another mill. 13.02, 13.03. So I'll change my tool now for another tool and see if I can just run across the face to get a better finish. That's the bore's finished, and I've just taken the sharp edges off with some emery. I've set the part up in the milling machine. It's still attached to the bar, it's not parted off yet. I'm just using a little V-block in the vise to hold it upright. I've centred on the hole in the middle, and then I've zeroed it and I've moved across 7mm, and now I'm just going to put a small centre drill mark there. So that's a 1.6mm hole on a 14mm pitch circle. So I'll go back to the other hole. Thank you. chattering you can hear there is the parting off blade hitting the two holes that are going through. Just cleared that. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll continue this project next time on Enots Engineering.